know which is the company at the talk of the town? Reliance Industry. Their proposed reorganization of O2C business of RIL. So many of you are already holding this company. Let us check what is it for us. Whether this proposed reorganization structure is going to affect our current shareholding, current finances, or what? So I, Piyush Patel, on behalf of Profit From It, we are going to discuss on Reliance Industry. Very well known that Reliance Industry is the company with around 13 lakh crore market cap. That is the highest among any company of India. Reliance Industry not only enjoys highest market cap, but Reliance is the company with highest sales along with the company with highest net profit of India. Definitely, if something is going on, some reorganization is going on, we need to check there. So let us check what is in it for me. So before we discuss, let me tell you that anything which we are going to discuss here is for education purpose and not for any tip giving. Profit From It never gives or provide tip. Before taking any decision, we should check the data on our own. What is Reliance Industry and how it has reached the huge 13 lakh crore market cap? Reliance has built 3 mega growth engines, which continue to create significant shareholder value. Yes, my dear friends. So this Reliance is not a car, but this huge truck is moving on 3 mega growth engine. Number one is Reliance O2C, oil to chemical businesses. Number two is Jio Digital Life. And number three is Reliance Retail. All sales profit or market cap comes from these 3 engines. Reliance Industries with $36 billion, that is largest available capital, raised in India through right issue and stake sales in businesses. We just saw this right issue few months back, which got a very good response from investors. So first we will talk about Reliance Oil to Chemical. This is the largest and most complex single site refinery at Jamnagar with 1.4 MMBPD crude refining capacity, vertically integrated portfolio across petrochemicals value chain. It's among lowest cost positions and global top 10 ranking in key products. Ongoing talks is with Aramco for one of the largest downstream transactions going to happen in India. RIL BP 51:49 fuel retail JV at enterprise value of $2 billion. So $2 billion is around, we can say it's 15,000 crore value. It is the largest FDI in India's fuel retail sector. We can say, yeah, Reliance O2C is a global leader and one of the long-term winners. What about Jio Digital Life? Largest digital service provider in India with 41 crore plus subscribers as per quarter three. Reached in less than 4 years since launch of service. That's amazing thing. We already know that yes, Bharti is also having around 40 crore subscriber, but those subscribers are compounded from Africa as well as India. And they are in business more than decade old. Jio, we should say that yes, they are having huge growth. Just in 4 years, they have reached to even a decade-old player's subscriber base. Fantastic growth. They are the first operator to cross 40 crore subscriber in a single country market. Strategic investment. We saw by Facebook and Google, and investments by Mark Financial Investors, which totaling to $21 billion for 32% stake in Jio Platforms Limited. If we convert 22 billion, we can say, yes, this deal was worth around 1.5 lakh crore. And that was also worth 33% stake. So we can say that Jio Platform is having around 5 lakh crore market cap. So if you now get total of around 15 lakh crore market cap of Reliance Industry, as you can see, 5 lakh crore comes from Jio Digital alone, which is a young company. Just 4 years back, it has launched third major engine is Reliance Retail. So what is Reliance Retail? Friends, 64 crore footfall. If subscriber base is important for digital company, then footfall is important for retail. 64 crore footfall with a diversified product portfolio of groceries, fashion and lifestyle, consumer electronics and connectivity across 12,200 stores across 3 crore square feet. So you can think what a large scale is Reliance Retail. They are having around 1.6 lakh crore turnover, which is 5 times more than DMart. So if you combine all the other players like DMart, Aditya Birla, Tata, even Shopper Stop, they all are not doing the same turnover which Reliance Retail alone is doing. So they are playing the big game here, Reliance Retail. Combining these all three things, we can say here that if 5 lakh crore market cap comes from Jio Digital, then what comes from Reliance Retail? You can see investments from Silver Lake Partners, KKR, GA, TPG, Mubadala, GIC, this is not our Indian GIC, Singapore, TIF and ADIA, total that you have 40,000 crore stake for just 10%, logically tells you that this should be around having market cap of 4 lakh crore, total market cap. So now you may can know that if you divide your 13 to 15 lakh crore market cap into these three mega growth engines, these new engines are also worth equal distribution, right? So we can say Reliance is not a single company. They are moving with the big, big growth engine. Reliance Industry has created 1.3 times more shareholder wealth than any other company in India over the past 25 years. O2C business reorganization, setting the context. Reliance Industry Limited's unprecedented growth in the last decade has been driven by significant growth in O2C business and rapid scale-up of new consumer business, that is digital and retail. In the real term, I should accept that real growth was seen from digital and retail, because these both segments were nothing few years back. Strong underlying performance of each business has resulted in a strong and diversified growth and earnings profile. Each business will pursue its own independent growth opportunities and create value. Reliance has initiated the process of carving out oil to chemical business into an independent subsidiary. This presentation sets out the rationale and process of O2C reorganization to seek shareholders and creditors' approval. So, what are the rationale behind this oil to chemical business reorganization? Number one, independent growth company enables focused pursuit of opportunities across oil to chemical value chain. Second, enhanced efficiencies through self-sustaining capital structure and dedicated management team. Third, it will facilitate value creation through strategic partnerships and attract dedicated pools of investor capital. Fourth, reorganization will be beneficial to all stakeholders of Reliance. Management control of O2C continues with Reliance. Existing O2C operating team moves with transfer of business. No dilution of earnings or any restriction on cash flows. Even RIL is expected to retain its investment grade international and domestic AAA credit ratings. So these are the rationale behind this reorganization. So what we are going to talk today is 5 points. One first point would be Reliance oil to chemical unique fully integrated platform. So in the real term, what is O2C? Number two, proposed reorganization of O2C. Third, we will see some financial performance of O2C pre and post. Fourth, we will see RIL and O2C post reorganization. So what effects this reorganization will give to RIL. And fifth, key considerations. So let us first discuss on RIL, oil to chemical, fully integrated platform. So what is O2C business for Reliance? Yeah, it's a world-class assets of global scale. 1.4 MMBPD crude refining capacity. That's the largest single-site refinery complex globally. 38.4 MMT of petrochemicals production last year. 20 consecutive years of outperformance over regional benchmark. Fourth largest producer of PTA globally. 21.1 complexity index. Second largest producer of PX globally. Number one largest PET coke gasifier globally. They are having total 12 manufacturing facilities, out of those 9 in India and 3 in Malaysia. We all knew well that they have pioneered vertical integration and conceived oil to chemical concept well ahead of industry. So let us see how they are generating significant benefits through deep integration. First, if you look for Jamnagar super site, see world's largest and most integrated oil to chemical complex. It's the world's largest ROGC with downstream LDPE MEG plants. Top decile refinery performance and top quartile cracker cost. Largest single location PX facility worldwide. Cracker integrated sites at Hazira, Dahej, Thane and Vadodara. These are their petrochem sites. So here we can see value add from integrated polyester, polymer, elastomer value chains. Strategic location and dedicated infrastructure for logistics cost advantage. And third is ethane imports. Virtual pipeline for import of ethane from surplus US market to RIL crackers. So as you can see, RIL is best positioned globally to sustain growth and profitability over industry cycles. Robust portfolio catering to growing consumption market. Margin capture across conversion chain is their goal, with reduced exposure to individual product cyclicality, counter cyclicality between polymers and polyester. For example, in fuels, in this portfolio, they have gasoline, gas oil, ATF. Associated industries of use is transportation fuels. In polymers, There is PEPP, PVC. Associated industry is construction, agriculture, automobile, consumer goods. They have elastomers with product EBR, SBR, butyl rubber. Their industry application is in tires or automobiles. They have aromatics and fiber intermediates with the products PTA, EOE and PX. Associated industry is polyester and textile industries. They have polyesters with PFY, PSP, PSF, PET. Associated industries, textile, apparel industry and even beverages. So Pan India distribution network and customer connect, only company globally with integration from oil to polymer, chemical, polyester and elastomers. Integrated Pan India fuel, retail and mobility solutions. Number one growth, India expected to be fastest growing fuel market globally. 1400 plus their own existing retail outlets with Reliance. 5500 targeted retail outlets in the next 5 years. 2x Reliance outlet throughput with respect to industrial average. To be India's largest and most preferred provider of mobility, including EV charging and low carbon solutions. Digital technology and extensive distribution network key enablers to bring cleaner and affordable option to consumers. You already know that Reliance Industry and BP have formed a 51-49 JV that includes retail service station network and aviation stations. High quality retail assets with a growth rate 3x industry on the back of unique value propositions. So this all might be positive points for O2C, but we should understand that even investors are worried that this O2C's average growth can affect overall Reliance industry. So now, considering this talks on Reliance O2C business, we can assume that yeah, Reliance is committed to grow their O2C business also. So in coming time, we may see that Reliance get growth from all the way. So by throwing this type of reorganization of O2C, Reliance management is clear to investor that we are going to focus our O2C business also. Get prepared. And that's a positive thing. But will it affect my shareholding? What I will get Reliance retail share? Some people are talking about. Do we get Reliance Jio share? No, friends. Let us discuss what will happen. So as we can see, this is the shareholding structure on left side. It's current shareholding structure, and on right side, the shareholding structure is post organization. As you can see, currently promoter group is 49.14. It will be same even post reorganization. Same for DII, which are 12.54, FII is 24.49 and public 13.83. It would be same even post reorganization. Then what would be change? As we can see, Reliance OTC Limited would be wholly owned subsidiary 100% under Reliance Industry. So OTC reorganization result in no change in shareholding of Reliance. Kindly note it down, no change in shareholding of RIL. So what is important? Resultant corporate structure of Reliance Industry on appointment date. What will be? As you can see, below Reliance Industry, there would be 100% subsidiary of OTC subsidiary, where refining and marketing, petrochemicals would be there. There, 51% Reliance BP Mobility Limited and 49% stake of BP. 100% stake of Reliance Global Energy Services Singapore Private Pte Limited. 100% of Reliance Global Energy Services UK. 100% of Reliance Ethane Pipeline and 74% of Reliance Sibur Elastomers and 25% for Sibur. Then comes 85.1% subsidiary of Reliance Retail Venture Limited. 66.3% subsidiary of Jio Platform Limited. It comes another segment for oil and gas and others. Very all refining, marketing, petchem asset will be transferred to O2C. Timeline and approvals. Appointment date, O2C scheme becomes effective from 1st January 2021. Approvals required are SEBI and stock exchanges, which approval are already received. Equity shareholders and creditors, regulatory authorities and income tax authorities, NCLT from Ahmedabad and Mumbai. Timeline, scheme filed with NCLT already on 3rd February 21, shareholding meeting quarter 1 22, creditors meeting quarter 1 22, and expect to receive order from NCLT Mumbai and Ahmedabad in quarter 2 22. So approval process has commenced and is expected to be completed by Q2 FY22. So now is the time to check financial performance of O2C in the context of RIL. So as we can see in the Reliance Industries consolidated financial performance, financial year 17, you can see total turnover of 45 billion. Out of this total turnover, O2C business was $39 billion. So we can say that majority of the turnover in 2017 was coming from O2C. In 2018, total was 59, where O2C was 48, while other, we can see here, just 11 billion. But today is the different case. You can see that other businesses are growing better. Last year, that is financial 21, financial 20, you can see that out of $90 billion, 62 was O2C and other businesses have grown well. So that's not a positive point for O2C. We can see here that other businesses are growing well while O2C's performance was not so good. Yes, right now they are having a very good cash flow, but growth is not there in this flow. Even in EBITDA, a profit, you can see that these years out of $13 billion profit, only $5 billion was from O2C, while other was from other businesses like Jio and retail. So we can see that in the total bunch of Reliance, other businesses are growing well, and that is the reason they are looking for focus on O2C. Balance sheet post reorganization, we can see loan to O2C $25 billion in assets, and in liabilities total borrowing of $33 billion. So O2C undertaking to be transferred to a wholly owned subsidiary at tax net worth, tax neutral for RIL. Consideration for O2C assets funded by interest bearing loan from RIL to O2C. Efficient mechanism to upstream cash, including any potential capital receipts in O2C. So Reliance very well positioned with high level of cash to pursue growth. If we see borrowings of $33 billion, then we should also see total equity of 45. Reorganization has no impact on Reliance Industry Limited's consolidated financial position. No change in RIL's cost of capital and borrowings. So let us see Reliance Industry and OTC post reorganization. Fourth important point. Reliance after O2C reorganization, what remains in Reliance? Existing businesses and investment like upstream oil and gas, retail including investments in subsidiaries, digital services including investment in subsidiaries, O2C including investment in subsidiaries, financial services, centralized treasury, others, international trading divisions and textiles. New businesses, new energy and new material business, digital platform, ecosystem and incubation platform. So Reliance vision to be net carbon zero by 2035. Opportunity to accelerate new energy and new material business based on Reliance vision of clean and green development. Build an optimal mix of reliable, clean and affordable energy and storage using solar, wind and batteries. Accelerate transition to a hydrogen economy. Develop portfolio of advanced and specialty materials. Deploy next generation technologies to combat climate change. O2C strongly positioned to capture new growth opportunities. Goal is to maximize crude to chemical conversion and create a sustainable, holistic, circular materials feedstock. Like crude plus feedstock is equal to high value chemicals. When waste recycling could get end products and waste. O2C will focus on recycling and circular economy, reducing carbon footprint, technologies to convert crude and feedstock to monomers and derivatives, next generation tech to capture and use carbon side, cater to growing demand for materials in India, leading energy company in carbon neutral world. So what are the potential consideration for Reliance shareholders? Number one, four high growth engines driving value creation. First high growth engine was O2C, growth from high value downstream chemicals and material. Second is digital, geo, connectivity and scaling up of digital platforms. Third is retail, consumer led growth, leveraging technology and omni-channel presence. And fourth, new material and new energy, clean, green and affordable energy. So new Reliance, a incubation platform, incubate new growth platform through adoption of new transformative technologies in collaboration model. Third, O2C reorganization is the potential consideration. Creation of pure play O2C platform could attract high quality strategic partners and capital. Independent, self-funded O2C company focused on pursuing new growth opportunities. Efficient upstreaming of cash to RIL from O2C. No earning dilution or any restriction on cash flows. So potential for re-rating reflecting value of each growth business. So now at last, let us move to conclusion. Ye sab ke baad conclusion kya hai? It's beneficial for all stakeholders as per Reliance. O2C reorganization creates an independent global scale growth engine for RIL with strong cash flow generation potential. Number two, no impact on Reliance consolidated financial as we have seen. Investment grade international and domestic AAA credit rating. Third, O2C subsidiary facilitates participation by strategic and financial investors for value discovery and unlocking. Fourth, RIL will further accelerate its new energy and new material business towards its vision of clean and green energy development. Fifth, potential for re-rating and sustainable value creation. Sixth, consent process to be completed by quarter 1, 22. NCLT approval expected by quarter 2, 22. These were conclusion by RIL. Let us as an investor also conclude here that till now we were fully confident on Reliance Jio as well as Reliance Retail, as these both were their growth engines, high growth, and they are increasing their share. But there was a problem in O2C business as we were not seeing any growth. If you look on the charts of Reliance, you will be able to find that yeah, on the longer horizon, Reliance have created huge wealth, but during 2007 to 2017, whole 10 years, they were not able to grow well because they were depend on totally O2C business. But as we saw consumption growing in India, we saw retail, we saw geo growth high, and the current growth in Reliance, major stake comes from retail and Jio. So if O2C business could also perform well, then a concern for investor about O2C would go, and we may see Reliance becoming high growth engine. We can learn from the above chart that over the period of time, Reliance have created huge wealth for their stakeholder, consistent profit making, consistent dividend giving. But during 2007 to 17, that is long 10 years, we have seen a muted phase where businesses were not growing. Post 2017, we saw huge growth in their retail and digital business, which has given them huge boom. So current growth in Reliance major stake comes from retail and digital. If O2C business could also perform well, then the concern of investors about muted phase can vanish, and we may see huge growth in Reliance. Currently, as we can see, since last 4 months, Reliance is in correction mode. All investors who want to accumulate can do SIP during this type of correction mode. If we get the opportunity to buy it near 1600, that would be a good opportunity to buy. Buy during corrections, accumulate during corrections, so that when the growth engines like retail and digital media would boom, you can reap the fruits. We may see multi-year rally here. So this was all about Reliance reorganization. We have created this video because many people were thinking that we are going to get Reliance retail share and Reliance Jio share. No, this is nothing about Reliance retail and Jio. It's only about O2C. So thank you so much and best of luck to everybody. Jai Hind. If you like the video, can like it and share with your friends. Goodbye.